Dr. Jyoti Nair, and I will be dealing today with interference, crossing over, mapping, and interference. Today's topic is on linkage, crossing over, mapping, and interference. We have done a lot of work on Mendel, and we have studied and we are aware of the work that was done by Mendel in genetics and the two laws that was presented by Mendel. However, Mendel's law of independent assortment is not universal and it is limited to only those genes which are present on different chromosomes. The number of genes are far more than the number of chromosomes that are present. So each chromosome will have many genes present on it and all of them will be inherited together and will not segregate. Variation from Mendel's law of independent assortment was first observed by Bateson and Punnett while they were working on sweet pea, that is Lathyrus odoratus. The definition of linkage is all the genes that are present on a chromosome will be inherited together as a single unit. Less is the distance between the two genes, more is the tendency of them being inherited together. All the genes of the chromosome will constitute a single linkage group. The number of linkage groups in a particular organism will be equal to the haploid set of chromosomes that are present in the organism. We can determine whether the genes are linked or not by assessing the F2 progeny or the test cross progeny. If the parental types are much more than the recombinant types and there is a variation in the ratio of Mendelian ratio of the F2 and the test cross progeny, then we know that the two genes, they are linked together. There are two phases of linkage. One which is called as a coupling phase, in which you find that both the genes of the wild type, of the similar type, for example the wild type or the mutant type, will come from the same parent, and this is what is called as the coupling phase. For example, in Drosophila, if the female flies are red-eyed with normal wings and they are crossed to the males which are purple-eyed with vestigial wings, purple eyes and vestigial wings are the mutant types coming from the male parent and they will be inherited together. Similarly, the red eyes and the normal wings are coming from the female parent and they are inherited together. These are said to be in the coupling phase. The next phase of linkage is the repulsion phase or the trans phase, where the females are red-eyed with vestigial wings with one dominant trait and one recessive trait. They are mated to the males with purple eyes and normal wings, where purple eyes is the recessive trait and normal wings is the wild type. In this case, each chromosome will carry one dominant allele for a gene and for the other gene it will be a recessive allele. This condition is called as a repulsion phase. The genes that are present, which are linked together, they will be inherited together, but a process called crossing over can separate the genes. Crossing over is a phenomenon where there is an exchange of chromosomal segments between non-sister chromatids of a homologous pair of chromosomes. This results in the recombination of genes. Crossing over can occur between sister chromatids or can be occur between chromatids of non-homologous chromosomes. Now, crossing over can also occur between sister chromatids, but there will not be any recombination of genes. As we know that the pair of homologous chromosome, one of them is from the paternal side and the other is from the maternal side. The two sister chromatids will have the same alleles, so there will not be any recombination of the genes. Crossing over between non-homologous chromosomes cannot occur because pairing will occur only between homologous chromosomes. More is the distance between the linked genes, the frequency of crossing over will be much more. This chromosomal mapping can be done with the help of linkage and crossing over. Linkage maps, which are also called as chromosomal maps, are imaginary lines on which the genes are represented, and these genes are separated by points or distance equal to the percentage frequency of recombination. They are not the actual value. They are the calculated value. The actual value will be given in base pairs or kilobases. Here, the map unit is given in morgans. One map unit is equal to the percentage, 1% frequency of crossing over, that is the distance between the genes, that is the distance between the two linked genes. Mapping between two linked genes is called as two-point test cross. Mapping of genes using two linked genes and analyzing the test cross progeny can be done by calculating the percentage frequency of recombination between the two linked genes. The formula used is number of recombinants by total progeny into 100. In a two-point test cross, the progeny that are obtained are of four types, of which the maximum two are the parental types and the least two are the recombinant types. We can also map three linked genes. In three linked genes, you can map the distance between the first and second gene, second and third gene, first and the third gene. And not only can we map the distance between the genes, we can also determine the gene order, that is, the gene which is present in the center. In three-point test cross, eight test cross progeny are obtained. Of these, the maximum two are the parental types, the least two are the double crossover types, and of the four intermediate ones, two are single crossover one and two single crossover two. To determine the gene order, a double crossover is performed using the maximum two parental types. The genotype of these are taken and a crossover is performed. This double crossover genotype, if it matches with the double crossover genotypes that is given in the problem, which are the least two types, then the gene order is correct. Otherwise, they have to be rearranged to get the correct gene order. For example, if capital ABC and small ABC are the genotypes of the parents and the genotype of the double crossover is capital A, small b, small c and small a, small b, capital C, then when you do a test cross using the sequence A, B and C, you will get capital A, small b, capital C, small a, capital B, small c, which is incorrect. However, if you use the sequence A, C and B, you will get capital A, small c, capital B, small a, capital C, small b, and this is the correct order as per the genotype given for the least two types in the problem statement. To determine the distance between the first and second gene, a single crossover is performed between the first and the second gene using the correct gene order. And their values are substituted in the formula, map distance is equal to single crossover 1 plus double crossover divided by total progeny into 100. To determine the distance between the second and third gene, a similar single crossover is performed between the second and third gene and their values are substituted in the formula, map distance is equal to single crossover 2 plus double crossover divided by total progeny into 100. To map the distance between the first and the third gene, the formula used is single crossover 1 plus single crossover 2 divided by total progeny into 100. The next part of the topic is on interference. In multiple crossovers, where there are more than two crossing over, two or more than two crossing over, crossing over in one region may affect the frequency of crossing over in the adjacent regions. This is called as interference. Interference I is calculated as 1 minus C, where C is the coefficient of coincidence. The value of C can be determined by taking the ratio of observed frequency of double crossover to the expected frequency of double crossover. Observed frequency of double crossover is the values of the double crossover progeny which is given in the problem statement, that is, the least two values. The expected frequency of double crossover is the product of single crossover 1 and single crossover 2. We are taking the product of the two values as the two crossing over events, single crossover 1 and single crossover 2, are independent events. Here, we are calculating the expected frequency, which is the probability of a double crossover that is occurring. Whenever we use probability, and if the two events are independent events, then the product rule applies. There are three types of interference. In case the observed frequency of double crossover is equivalent to the expected frequency of double crossover, then C value will be 1. In that case, I will be 1 minus 1, which is equal to 0. This indicates no interference. That is, crossing over in one region will not affect the frequency of crossing over in the adjacent regions. In case the observed frequency of double crossover is less than the expected frequency of double crossover, then I is less than 1. In this case, it is a positive interference. Crossing over in one region will interfere with the frequency of crossing over in the adjacent region. That is, they lower the frequency of crossing over in the adjacent regions. if the observed frequency of double crossover is greater than the expected frequency of double crossover, then I will be a negative value. It indicates negative interference, wherein crossing over in one region will enhance or increase the frequency of crossing over in the adjacent regions. We will use this theory part in the practical class to solve some problems. Thank you.